Got your pork shoulder, that's gonna go right into your pot. And now you're gonna take a can of Dr. Pepper. That gets poured right over our pork. This is about a 4-pound pork shoulder. There you go, about half that can should be good. That's gonna help tenderize and sweeten the meat. Now we're gonna add some seasoning. This one's my favorite, all-purpose Wingman. This has got salt, pepper, paprika, garlic. We're gonna load it up. And you know what's great? This is veteran-owned. Check that out, I'll put a link in the comments. And we're gonna top that with some barbecue sauce. I'm using the Ray's. Y'all have told me this is the best barbecue sauce to use. We're just gonna give it a generous squeeze, and then you can add more later if you like. And lastly, we're gonna top that with the remainder of our onion. This is gonna be delicious. We're gonna cook this either on high for 4 to 5 hours, or even better yet, low and slow for 7 to 8 hours. But I'm not done cooking yet, because now I'm gonna make some homemade coleslaw. All right, we're gonna make some coleslaw now. This is some home style coleslaw. I've got my new device that I'm trying out here, cabbage shredder.
I think you're just making a mess.
Yeah, I'm not. You know, it's pretty good. It's, is it better than just using a knife? I'm not sure, you be the judge. What do you think? Is this a good device? Am I doing a good job of it? Or am I embarrassing myself? You tell me. Either way, we're gonna make some yummy coleslaw in a minute. All right, so we've got about 4 cups of shredded cabbage, and in addition to that, we also have a Band-Aid now. So the moral of the story is, be very careful when you're in the kitchen, especially using new gadgets, because I cut myself, so be careful with that. But we're gonna keep going, powering through. I'm gonna add a cup of shredded carrot as well. And now we're gonna make some dressing for our coleslaw. So I've got another bowl. We're gonna take some apple cider vinegar. We're gonna do about 1 1/2 tablespoons. We're gonna add that to our bowl. Okay, that was closer to 2 tablespoons, but that's okay, I like the acid. Now we're gonna go with some sugar as well. You're gonna need about 1 1/2 tablespoons of sugar. And we also need some mayo. It's in the fridge. Would mayo? You grab it for me, please?
All right, some mayo. There it is. Mayo.
Great, thank you. Y'all tell me, what is the best brand of mayo? There's been some heated debate on this on our page. We're gonna use about 2/3 cup. Measure out about 2/3 cup, but you could do a little bit more, a little bit less, depending on what you want. And we're gonna add some salt and pepper, about 1/4 teaspoon. You can find links to all of our gadgets, including these, in the comments. And we're gonna give everything a whisk. We're gonna add that to our cabbage and carrots. And people are often saying too, why don't you scrape out the bowls? Well, I usually do that off camera, because see, it's kind of boring and tedious, and it's not really that interesting. But since some of y'all are always worried about it, I decided to go ahead and keep it in just this once. But that normally happens off camera. Now we're gonna toss everything together. Now, what else would you add to this one? Tell me what your best recipe for homemade coleslaw is. It's looking good. We are almost ready to taste test our pulled pork as well, but first it's time for the riddle of the day. Let's see if we can get this one right. If you have 3, you have 3. If you have 2, you have 2. If you have 1, you have none. What am I? Wow, that's a really interesting riddle. I don't even know the answer. Kyle's gonna have to tell me this one, but I want you to give me your guess. First, tell me where you're from, then let us know what your guess is. I'll be putting the answers in the comments for you. Y'all, this smells so good. Let's check it out. Let's see. Okay, that meat is falling apart. That's exactly what we wanted. Now we're gonna take this and plate it up, add a little bit more barbecue sauce. We're gonna make some sliders, and then I'm gonna add that coleslaw I made earlier too. Time for the taste test. Doesn't that look good? I made us some sliders, and I've got my homemade coleslaw. I'm so excited to taste test that.
I'm so excited too. I'm coming right now.
Now definitely make sure that you cook that on low to get nice and tender meat. Yeah. You ready to taste test?
I'm so ready for this, by the way. This is like midnight.
We've been waiting all day for this.
It took a lot longer to make.
I started the crock pot a little bit later than I meant to. So it truly is. If you look at the video, you'll see 11:41 p.m. is what time we're actually finishing this. But how does it
taste?
They are
delicious. Mm. You did good.
This is so good. That's one of the best things I've ever made.
Dr. Pepper, huh?
Mm-hmm. Wait, we almost forgot the coleslaw. Here, right. Don't forget the coleslaw.
Mm.
How'd we do?
That is good. That's got a good flavor to it.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
That's good, isn't it? I think it's that apple cider.
There's a lot of apple cider vinegar. Perfect kick to it.
Mm, I like it.
Yo, pulled pork sliders, crock pot, that's a winner. Mm-hmm. Let me know what you thought of this one.
Have another bite.